Now, this is it's a really unusual story, this. It's a brilliant idea for a fundraiser. Pendleside Hospice is launching an attempt to set a world record for the largest gathering of people dressed as witches. This unusual attempt is taking place in September. Helen McVey is Pendleside's chief executive, and I'm delighted to welcome Helen to the show this morning. How are you doing, Helen?
Hi, Sharon. Yeah, I'm doing well, thank you. Very excited about this event.
This is brilliant. And before we talk about it, Helen, do you mind if I just ask you, what did you want to be when you grew up?
I did want to be a cook, and then I did my work experience at Rosendale Hospital, which isn't there anymore, when I was 14. And then from that point of view, just wanted to be a nurse, and that's what I did. I trained to be a nurse, and that's what brought me to Pendleside.
Amazing, amazing. I imagine you're really enjoying what you're doing now as well.
I do. I love every day coming to work. There's not a day that I don't enjoy coming to work, and the reward that you get from doing a job that you like is really good.
I bet it is. Yeah. How long have you been there, Helen?
I'm just coming up to 18 years at Pendleside. So
wow.
I started working on the day services unit as a day service lead and nurse, and then was clinical manager and then chief exec for about 6 or 7 years now.
Incredible. Well, I'm loving the idea behind your world record attempt. Tell me about it. Witches.
Yeah, so witches. So 10 years ago, we managed to break the world record for having the largest gathering witches. And we got 600 witches together at that point. Somebody came over from Spain, and we thought that was fantastic that they came over. But the year after, they took the record off us. So I think they just come over to have a look about what we'd done.
Oh, no.
Yeah, so they brought the world record the year later, getting 1,200 witches together. So just before COVID, we thought that we want to get this record back and bring it back to Pendle, where we believe it belongs with the Pendle witches.
Of course.
And at the same time, raise the money for Pendleside. So we got all our plans in motion, and then obviously COVID hit, and that was the end to our plans. So as we're coming out of the pandemic and life's turning a bit more to normal, we thought, actually, let's bring that event back, and it'd be a really great event to bring back and get our community together, have some fun, and also raise money at the same time.
So you mentioned that the figure now, is it 1,200 that you need to beat?
Yeah, it's 1,200, over 1,200 that we need to beat, but we've got an aspiration to have 2,022 witches together for 2,022.
So that where are you going to find them? Where are you going to find all these witches?
We just need our community to come forward and join us for this event. We're hoping that people will be excited about it as we are, and we'll sign up to becoming a witch for a day. We've got a festival planned in Barrowford Park. So we've got a really great day starting at 11 o'clock that day on the 17th of September. And running to 8 o'clock at night, we've got bands on, we've got a sponsored walk, besides the gathering of the witches as well. So it's going to be a great family event for people to come down to. So we're hoping our community get behind us, and we're also speaking to like local businesses and things like that, asking yeah. them whether they'll get their employees to come down and things as well. So.
And as you said there, Helen, it's been an awful 2 years more, you know, with the pandemic. And of course, it's hit fundraising across the board, hasn't it? So you've got a lot of work to do to get back to where you would have been.
Yeah, absolutely. It's been hard for everybody, hasn't it, Sharon, at the end of the day. But yeah, particularly from a fundraising point of view, our fundraising really, when the pandemic hit, was wiped out. We couldn't do the things that we normally do to fundraise. And luckily, thanks to our local community, they've kept us going and kept us throughout this. But ultimately, I think having been able to bring events back is just really important to us, because they're things that bring our community together, raise awareness of what we do, and also at the same time raise money for what we do. Our services, we've had to sort of change our services and adapt our services and increase our services to support the response to COVID. And so the fundraising is just so important, because to keep our services running and make sure we support the people we do is just really important for
absolutely.
Us.
Absolutely. So, right, you're looking for 2,022 witches. You need these witches for this event in September. Who qualifies? How do you become a witch, and how can people get involved?
Yeah, so if people go to our website, you can sign up to come in on the day, being a witch for the day. All the details about it are on the website. You can ring our fundraising team if you've got any queries as well. There'll be lots of our Facebook page, all our social media, there's lots of details. We've actually got a dedicated Facebook page, WitchFest, so that all our news about the event we'll be sharing on there. So we've got some great celebrities supporting the event as well.
Brilliant.
So that's really good. So so we'll have updates from them as well as we go through. So
fantastic. Yeah. Well, keep us posted, and hopefully we'll be able to help you find some witches between now and September. Helen, it's been really nice to chat. Thank you for your time.
Thanks, Sharon.
You're more than welcome. Thank you. That's Helen McVey there, who is the chief executive at Pendleside Hospice. It's a world record attempt for the largest gathering of people dressed as witches. Could you take part? Do you fancy that, being a witch for a day? They only need 2022. And as Helen said there, all the information is on their website or on social media. But if you need a helping hand, just give us a bell here, 0800 7833 583.